Hi everyone, this is Siddharth and this is my first vlog. So today I am moving to Canada, specifically Vancouver, and my flight is in Air India, and today is 22nd of January. So I am at the airport and my parents are there to drop me. So stay tuned for this video. I thought I'll make a vlog from New Delhi to Vancouver, and we'll tell you about the travel scene which is there in COVID, and what are the baggage allowance for Air India, and few basic things. So stay tuned, keep watching.
Okay,
done. So guys, we have finally checked in, and hamara security bhi ho chuka hai. So a lot of students have doubt regarding the baggage allowance for Air India for students who are flying for the first time. So for all the students who are traveling for the first time, they can carry 3 bags, like 23 kgs each, because I also checked recently with Air India and they were saying that we have changed this policy, but it's not like that. It is still legit and you can carry 3 bags. So now we are just heading towards our boarding. We have it in next 15-20 minutes, so that's it. Regarding the flight, a lot of students prefer Air India just because of the baggage policy. But if we do not keep this policy in our mind, like 3 bags, then we can also prefer Air Canada, and there are other airways also, like British Airways. And the ticket that I did it like in first week of December for 22nd January, and it costed me around 50,000 INR. And now if like a week before, the rates were as high as 1,17,000, 1,20,000. So I think 50,000 is quite reasonable. Like if you book your tickets a month before your travel, then it will cost you in that range only 50,000, 60,000. So this is the cost of one-way ticket. And my flight is a direct flight. It's around 15 to 16 hours. And let's see. I also got my COVID test done in RT-PCR from a lab approved by ICMR. And its validity is 72 hours. And one thing also I would like to clear is that 72 hours validity is not required to be maintained till you enter Vancouver. That validity should be like, it should be valid while you come to the airport for your departure. So during the check-in, they checked my COVID test report. So I did it yesterday only, so it was valid. And this was about COVID. And now let's see, how is our journey to Canada? And guys, we also have duty free when we cross our security thing. We have duty free. If you want to buy anything, so you can buy, including liquor or any item that you feel like. Liquor is there, and perfumes and all, you can carry it also. Regarding Cayman bag. No one checks the weight of cabin baggage over here. So if you buy anything from duty free, you can keep that in your cabin bag only. So this was all about the cabin thing. And once you do your check-in, you submit all 3 luggage. Then you go and your passport is stamped, and they look and verify you with your passport and they stamp it. And then you go for directly to the security thing. They check for your cabin baggage and all items that are not that are prohibited and all. So once security is done, you are good to go. And this was like the process. And guys, if we talk about the quarantine thing, then if you are flying to Canada, then you are asked for your quarantine plan. So I am like studying my master's at UBC, and UBC is offering 2 weeks complimentary isolation plan for all the students who are traveling for the first time. So I have already booked that in UBC housing, and meals are also included in it, and it is free of cost, meals plus accommodation. So my quarantine plan is also fixed, so I shouldn't face a problem with that. So guys, we both are traveling together, and we are in same course at UBC, Masters of Food Science. So I thought I'll give you guys some idea regarding the timelines of our visa. So first of all, we'll have introduction with Vartika.
Hi guys, I'm Vartika, and I'm traveling with Siddharth for my masters in UBC. We are like course mates. So yes.
So what was your can you just explain something regarding the timelines, like when you applied for visa and when was your biometrics and?
Okay. So I applied for my visa on July 15th. Like how a regular process goes, but due to COVID, BFS were closed, so the processing got very late, and I got my AIP on 2nd September, but without my medical, my medical was not updated, and I got my AIP. After that, on 20th November, the BFS were open, and I booked my appointment, and I got the appointment for 27th November. Then I went for biometric, and my biometric was updated on my GIC account on IRCC, and then my medical got updated on 11th December, and then after that on 18th December I got my passport request, and then I sent my passport on 24th December, and I got it back on 8th January. So yeah, this is my timeline.
So normally the timeline is almost the same for everyone. We are fall intake students. We started our course in September, and the timelines are almost same for me also. I also applied in July. Then I had my biometrics. I received my AIP in September first week. Then same biometrics in November end. And then I received my passport request, and finally received the visa in December. So this was all about our timelines for our study visa. So